Hello everyone, today we are going to see the history and evaluation of Java. So what is Java? Java is a high level object oriented programming language. So what do you mean by a programming language? For communicating with computer, you need to know a language that it can understand, right? That is your programming language. Initially, you had machine language, which is in terms of zeros and ones, and it is much closer to your hardware, that is your processor. Then comes your assembly language, where this sequence of binary code are replaced by mnemonic codes like add, sub, move. Then comes your high level language, which is much friendly towards the developer, and you need a translator for converting this high level language into a machine language. So your Java is a high level language. So what is this object oriented? In high level language, there is an evaluation. You have structured language, procedural language, and object oriented. Object oriented language, you view everything in terms of object, right? Which we will discuss in elaborate in further sessions. So object oriented language, you view everything in terms of object. That is what your object programming language. So we will discuss about the development platform. And if you view Java as a development platform, you will have a JDK. You need a JDK or JRE, that is Java Runtime Environment, for running your Java program. So what is this Java Development Kit and what is your Java Runtime Environment? As a developer, if you want to write and execute a Java program, you need Java Development Environment, JDK. What the JDK will have means, not only Java, for any programming language you need an editor. Then that has to be that editor is meant for writing your program. Then you need to give this program as input to a compiler or a translator that will convert it into your machine readable form for execution, right? In same way, in Java, you write your source program, you save it with the Java extension, then you use a compiler, Java C, which takes your Java program and translates into a class file with extension .class, and you call this class file as bytecode. It is an important thing because this bytecode makes your Java platform independent, right? This bytecode is platform independent. This makes your Java write once and run anywhere. If you write Java in one system, that is the one having different processor architecture as well as your operating system, you can write your Java once and you can run it in another system which has different operating system and different processor architecture. That is because of this bytecode, sir. Then this bytecode will be taken to your JVM. Initially, your JVM will intake this bytecode through the class loader, and it will use your bytecode verifier to check whether this bytecodes are not going to may have any harmful instructions. Then it will either it can use your compiler or interpreter. Here it is given just-in-time compiler. We see what is just-in-time compiler, right? This bytecode will be converted to your machine code, which is ready for execution, right? So now first we will see what is JDK. For Java Development Environment, you need the complete setup. As a developer, you need to both for development as well as the running environment to execute your programmer. If I just want to run my program, then this portion is sufficient. Java Runtime Environment is sufficient to run my program. Whether I may be a developer or I may be an executor, I need your JVM for executing my programmer, right? So what is this just-in-time compiler? See, your bytecodes can either be compiled or interpreted. You use compiler to enhance the speed of your Java execution, right? That is what the thing. Okay, so now we know what is Java. Java is a high-level object-oriented programming language. The development environment, if you are going to develop, you need a JDK. If you are going to execute your Java program, your JRE is sufficient. Whatever may be the case, you need JVM for executing your program. And this JVM is platform dependent. For every processor, you will have the associated JVM. Only the bytecodes make Java platform independent, right? With this introduction, we will move for a short film to see what is the history of Java.
Today we'll learn about the history of Java. The history of Java is very interesting. Java was originally designed for interactive television, but it was too advanced technology for the digital cable television industry at the time. The history of Java starts with Green Team. Java team members initiated this project to develop a language for digital devices such as set-top boxes, televisions, etc. Later, Java technology was incorporated by Netscape. The principles for creating Java programming were simple, robust, portable, platform independent, secured, high performance, multi-threaded, architecture neutral, object-oriented, interpreted, dynamic, distributed. Java language project was initiated by James Gosling, Patrick Naughton, and Mike Sheridan in June 1991. Firstly, it was called Green Talk by James Gosling, and file extension was .gt. After that, it was called Oak, and was developed as a part of the Green Project. It was named Oak because Oak is a symbol of strength, and chosen as a national tree of many countries, like USA, France, Germany, Romania, etc. In 1995, Oak was renamed as Java, due to trademark issues by Oak Technologies. Java is an island of Indonesia where first coffee was produced, called Java Coffee. And on the 23rd of January 1996,
Okay, with this information about history, we will move back to the slides. So you could have gained some information from that video. Let us recollect what all the information we learned from that, right? Okay, so the Java was mainly developed for the embedded systems, and the team which was intended for developing it, you call it as Green Team. And they discussed some principles of Java, which we are not going to touch now. Then, who are all the founders of Java? And mainly, you call James Gosling as the father of Java. Then, initially, it was named as GreenTalk, and you use the file extension .gt. Now, we are using it as .java. Then, it was renamed as Oak. And due to trademark issues, it was renamed as Java in 1996. Okay, with this short introduction about history, we will see the path how the moved by your Java, right? Okay, so who are all the, we know Java is not the first high level programming language, right? So who could be the predecessor for your Java, or who, from which the Java concepts have been used, has been taken from which languages? Initially, you call C++ as C with classes. Most of the concept in your C is available in C++ with the additional feature of class. This special feature makes your C++ as object-oriented language. And for Java, these two languages are the predecessor. Java takes its syntax from C and structure from your C++, right? But still, there are something that makes your Java more peculiar. In C and C++, you have pointers. In Java, you don't have pointers. Pointers allow the program to access the memory location. Since that is not available in Java, it makes your Java more secure. And though your Java is an object-oriented language, it does not directly support your multiple inheritance. And then you don't have your operator overloading. Okay, with this small introduction, we will move for the evaluation of Java. Initially, the Java was released in Jan 1996 and it has taken its long way. And the latest version was Java Standard Edition 14, released on March 2020. And it is expected to get released your SE 15 by September 2020. Okay, so what are all the flavors you have in your Java? What this flavors means? Customized Java platform, you can say in that way. Your standard edition, if you want to develop a simple standalone applications for desktop, you can go for the standard edition development environment. If you are going to develop application for enterprise, where you need to involve with your clients and server, you need your servlets, you need your interaction with different environment, then you can go for your enterprise edition. If you are going to develop use Java for your mobile applications, then you can go for your micro editions. These are the flavors of Java, and you can have this references for further understanding. Thank you.